Hi, welcome to another video about Audi A2 project YoungTimer. In this video I will replace the engine oil and the oil filter. I bought this Mahle OC295, which should be okay for this engine. It is 1.4 petrol engine AUA type, and usually the oil replacement and everything is quite simple, and also here it is not very difficult, but it is a messy job. Why? Because of the location of the fuel filter. I will show you when I go forward with the replacement. First, of course, I need to leave the car in the front and remove the plastic engine under tray. I will put a link about lifting the car the proper way, and also how to remove the plastic engine under tray, and then I have full access to the nut for to the nut for removing the oil and everything. So let's go forward. And here I'm already ready. I'm already in my working clothes. The car is also ready. As you can see, it is lifted, and also the plastic engine under tray was removed, so that I will be able to work. Also, the boot was open, so that I will have access to the oil filter. But first, let's check what we need for this. So, definitely we need a fuel filter. So this is the Mahle. I have this metal that you used for baking. You will see why I will need this. Then we have the oil, of course. And here are the this is the copper washer for the screw that goes into the hole to drain the oil. And here we have 19. This is for that screw. Then I have here prepared for 27, because the new filter uses 27, but the factory filter, I presume that it is the factory filter, uses 30. So I will need this. And of course I have here also the torque wrench to use. I could do it by hand, but I will use it, because for the fuel filter it's 20 newton meters of torque, and for the nut, for the draining out the oil, it's 30 newton meters, so I will just use this filter. And now let me show you where are all the things that need to be replaced. So the oil filter is exactly down here, down below. Maybe if I turn this, it will be better seen. Yeah, it's down there. You can see for unscrewing it. So you need to unscrew it from up here. And why is this? Why is this location a little bit problematic? Okay, so let me go away, and now let me go down. So the fuel filter is the oil filter is somewhere around here, so I will go down and up. Let us check. And now you can easily see the fuel filter. So here is the exhaust, this is the exhaust, and the fuel filter is up there. So why I don't like this location and this such a big mess, because when you remove the fuel the oil filter, here it all goes out and it drains all over these things here. And this is where that baking metal comes in, because I try to put from below and then just here over, and the oil usually goes over here. I've already used this on my 2.0 TDI, which has also the very bad location for the fuel filter, and it works perfect. And now let us check where is the drain screw. So if here it is the, here is the middle of the car, let's say, here is the exhaust. If we go here back, here is the oil pan, and here we can see is the screw for releasing, for draining the oil. This is 19, so this is easy. It's not a problem. I will just open it, and here you can already see that there is some oil. And why oil leak? Because the I have a problem with the oil separator, which is up there, as you can see, it's a little bit leaking, and I've already ordered it, and I will replace it when I receive it. So now this is the start, and now I will just drain the oil out from this screw. Now I will that I have everything. I have here the can in which I will get the oil in, and here is the screw. So this is 19, and I will just unscrew it. Okay, it was not really a lot screwed very tightly, so I will just put here the can, and now I just unscrew it by hand. I think that it should be. Let me do it like this to be easier. That's it. Okay, and now I'll just use this one, the can up, so that the oil will not go on the floor. Okay, let's just do it like this, and the oil, it's almost out, and it's going out. You could hear the washer, the copper washer, that fell down. So I have a new one, so I will replace it. This is not a problem. It's always, you need to replace it so that it does not leak. And let's leave the oil out. As you can see, it's really dark color, black color, so it was already time to be replaced. Now I will just leave it to drain the whole oil out. Anyway, while the oil is still draining, I use this time, and I put this baking metal here, as you can see. So it is set under the oil filter, and here over this. So when the oil will leak, I hope it will go directly to this and down here, and instead of over all these parts here, over all these cables and holes and everything, so it will not be so dirty, and I will not need to clean it. So hopefully this will work. It worked on my diesel, and hopefully also here. Now I will wait for the oil to completely drain out, and then I'll put the drain plug back in. While I wait that the oil drains out, I will also prepare the oil filter. What do I mean with that? Well, I will just put a little bit of oil, new oil, fresh oil, around this rubber seal, so that it will seal a little bit better. So I'll just do it like this, and open this one, and here is a little bit of oil, and I'll use my finger and just put some oil, as you can see, so that it will seal nicely. It. Some mechanics also put in inside here the oil, but I will not, because if I would put it, I would just spill it everything because of the location of the oil filter. So this is it. The oil filter is prepared, and here is also the right 27, the key. And this is it. Okay, so now I will replace the oil filter. So oil filter is here. I have moved the oil catcher can so that it is just below the oil filter, as you can see. Here is already I have the wrench put on the oil filter, so that I just unscrew it. And here I will first just put this on, because it does not need to be opened. Now I will open it back, and let's go forward with the oil filter removal. Okay, so I will now unscrew it. It's quite hard. Okay, a Okay, it moves, so this is good. And that's it. Okay, let me just put it back on. Okay, let's see. It's a little bit problem here, but okay. Okay, so now, again, now it's already easier. Yeah, it's great. So this is it. Once more. Okay, it's in. Okay, now it's, it already goes like this. So now I will try with my hand if I will be able to unscrew it. Yeah, it already goes by hand, and now it's easy. Let me just put my wrench away, and the oil is already leaking. Let me just check. Yeah, it's going into the can. Perfect. And when you unscrew the oil filter, turn it up so that it will not leak down. Okay, so it's almost out. So, and now I have it not yet. Now I have it out, and I'm turning it up so that it will not leak towards all this stuff here. Now it's a little bit hard to get it out. Okay. Okay, and up. Yeah. That will be a problem. Okay, and it's almost out. Yeah. Huh. Okay, let me put it here. Okay, and it's out. As you can see, the old filter is out. I will just drain this into the where the oil goes, and I will put then the new filter. Okay, I have here now the new filter, but first I will just try to clean everything here that was that has some oil in. Okay, that's it. Yeah, and now I will just install the new filter. I'll just go in, down like this, and now I need to find the screw here. Okay, it's a little bit. Okay, I think that I found it. Yeah, and now I can just screw it back with hand. So this is it. Okay, and now I will need the 27 with the torque wrench set to, I think it is, it needs to be set to it is to 20 newton meters. So I'll just set it to 20 newton meters of torque. 20 newton, yeah, 20. Okay, that's it. And let me now just wrench. Yeah, it's 27, not 19. This is it. Okay, so torque wrench, as you can see, and just go down, and let me just connect it. Yeah, that's it. And I'm already pushing it down. That's it. Okay, needs to go to 20. It's set to 20, and that's it. This will slowly be enough. And it clicked. So this is it. Oil filter is replaced. Just take the, this is out, and that's it. This was quite easy. Now let's see what kind of mess was done below. If my hack worked. So there is a little problem. I forgot to press record when I was showing you how it was below. So sadly, I have already removed it. And as you can see here, the new filter is installed. Majority of the oil from the oil filter went down via this aluminium foil here. This aluminium foil, so it was good. Just a little bit went below it, so it is a little bit here. You can see a little bit of oil, but it is really, really little, so it's great. So this hack worked. And sorry again, but I forgot to press the record. Okay, now that the oil is drained, I think it's enough. I will just put in the screw. As you can see, I put also a new washer on it. So a copper washer, so that it will definitely seal. And I will just put it in. Okay, that's it. Now I can just clean this here. Okay, and now I just do it by hand. I will remove this, that's it, by hand. And this is it. And now I will use my torque wrench. I will set it to 30. So just set it to 30. This is it. And I will not be able to. Okay, so now this is a small problem. Okay, I will need to do it by hand. Just let me go for another ratchet. Okay, so it is 30 newton meters, but since I cannot get it in, I will just do it by hand. That's it, a little bit more. Don't over tighten it, because you can break here and then you have a problem. Now that the screw is in, the oil is drained and the oil filter is also replaced. Now I just need to put in the oil. So according to data, it should go around 3 to 3.2 or something like that liters, but I will put only a little bit less than 3. Why? Because I prefer to add the oil later than to drain it out if it is too much. Because if it is too much, then you can have a problem with catalytic converter. You can see here, it's nicely written. I hope that it is visible. So I will pour in a little bit less than 3 liters of oil. Then I will leave turn on the engine, leave it run for a few minutes, and so that the oil will circulate also into the fuel filter. And after that, I will check the oil level. Although this is with this factory oil dipstick is quite hard, but let's go. So when you are pouring the oil, don't pour it like this, because it will overflow. Pour it like this, you see, and so it should not spill. You can rest your you can see that I rest my left hand on this, on the here, so I have it, I don't move it too much. Let me check how much oil was this, so that I don't put too much oil in. As you can see, this is a 4 liter oil, so 1.5 liters. So I need to put almost 1.5 additional liter in. Okay. That's it. Let's check. Yeah, 2.5, just a little bit more, and then I will stop. I will later add the oil that it's needed. Okay, so let's see. No, a little bit more. That's it. Okay, I will stop here. And of course, you should not forget to put this back on. Just turn it around. This is it. And now I'm in the car. I will just turn the engine on. Leave it to run 2-3 minutes so that the engine oil will flow through the oil filter. And after that, I will check the level of oil and add as needed. Okay, so it turned on immediately. There is no engine oil light. So I'll just leave it a few minutes, 2-3 minutes, so that it heats a little bit and that the engine circulates through the, not the engine, that the oil circulates through the engine. And after that, I will check the level. Now I'll check the oil level. I left the car running for 3 minutes, and after that I left it 10 minutes so that all oil goes down. And let's see. Okay, let me just do it like this and put it back in, and then I will check it. Anyway, this oil dipstick is really not, does not show, it's not consistent, does not show always the same result, because for this engine, our engine, the normal dipstick was here, and they added this only for Audi A2 because it was meant that you do not open the bonnet. So I already ordered the parts for that dipstick, and I will publish a video in the future with that dipstick in, which should be the correct one, and it always shows the correct value of all oil level. So let's see now. And if I look, I think that it is only here at the bottom, really at the bottom. So I definitely need to add some oil. Okay. And if I look here, yeah, definitely. Okay. Like this, and this, I will do like this, and let's pour in some more oil. Okay, let me check, almost 3 liters, a little bit more. And this should be it, should be enough. So let us now check. Just let me do it like this. Okay. And let me just wait a little bit so that the oil goes down. Let's see if there is any change. Yeah, it's a little bit up, so it's at the minimum mark. So let's see what will happen now. Okay, like this. Let's check, wait a little bit. Let's see, yeah. It's, I don't know if it is visible, but it exactly at the minimum mark. So I will just put a little bit more oil. And after that, I will just run the engine a little bit more and then check. And when I get the, okay. This should be it, enough. And when I get the other dipstick, I will verify with that it's the correct level, oil level. So let us see now. Check. Yeah, it's almost at the middle. As if you, I don't know if it is visible, but it exactly at the middle. So this should be good. Let me just verify again. Okay, now it's a little bit below the middle, but it's still good. So I will just leave it like this, run the car a little bit more, and then add if needed. Definitely I will pull it up to the a little bit below the maximum, and that's it. And this was the whole process of replacing the oil and oil filter on the 1.4-hour engine. Relatively simple, but a really messy job because of the location of the oil filter. But okay, it's done now, and so for 2 years or 1 year, whatever, I will see how much kilometers will be done, but probably little. I will replace it again. Thank you for watching. I hope that this video helped, and drive safe, of course, and smile when you drive, because driving is fun. Bye.